Welcome back to another edition of DC Film Room's Game Film Analysis. Be sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter at DC Film Room.
In this week's film analysis, we'll break down number 89, Gavin Escobar. He was taken in the 2013 NFL Draft in the second round. He has most recently become a receiving threat for the Dallas Cowboys in the red zone, but its run-blocking ability is very questionable. Okay, we're going to start off by watching Gavin Escobar's touchdown passes. Here's his first one. He's lined up in the slot position. Now, he's going to run this little slant route, get past the safety, who blew his coverage, and just be wide open right inside the end zone. Let's watch the play and see what happens. Flies right past him, touchdown. About a 3-yard separation. Now, if you look closely, Gavin Escobar is actually, he doesn't have hands at all. These are actually very soft down feather pillows. He might have one of the softest hands on the team. From watching the film on this game and the previous game, he can catch almost anything Romo throws his way, and he's just now starting to build his trust in him. So keep your eye on him versus the Redskins in the next game. Let's go back and watch the play. All right, now right here, as you can see, Jason Witten is taking care of these two guys. This safety cheated over to take care of Terrence Williams, which leaves Gavin Escobar, our main guy who scores the touchdown, wide open. He sees this all this space right here, all this real estate for him. He's wide open because these two guys are checking down on Jason Witten, and then Terrence Williams draws over these two guys. This is definitely the safety's fault. He cheated over too much, and he should have maintained right here, and he would have been able to defend the pass probably. But Gavin Escobar wide open. Beautiful catch, though, but great thrown ball by Tony Romo. Here's a play from a different view. Romo hikes it. Looks over, sees Gavin open. Catches it right in the end zone. Easy catch. All right, here's Gavin Escobar's second touchdown pass. He's right here. Let's watch the play, and we'll see what happens at the end. I think I know what will happen. Gavin Escobar goes in motion and just gets past the defender and just a perfectly thrown football. Let's watch the pass again. It was a great catch. Watch the ball. Perfectly thrown. Now, if that ball... Right there, if that ball was thrown maybe, the ball's right here, if that ball was thrown maybe a foot short, it would have been blocked, of course. Right around here, this defender comes in, probably picks the ball off or swats it. Great throw by Tony Romo, but also a great catch by the feather hand, Gavin Escobar. Gets hit too. Kind of a light hit by the safety, but... Great job by Gavin Escobar to call onto the ball. Let's watch the play again. He goes in motion. Romo hikes it. He's not really the fastest guy. Gavin Escobar ran a 4.84 in the 40 during the draft 2 years ago. He's not going to burn you, but he is 6'6", and his hands can catch anything. They're like suction cups from an octopus. He just throws his hands up, and he'll bring it in. Definitely not a body catcher. Excellent catch. Good job, Gavin. All right, let's take a look at Gavin Escobar's route running. He's lined up in the slot position right around here, which he plays the best at if he's lined up on the inside or like the slot position pretty much. He's going to run this little 10-yard in, catch the ball. Great route, though. Great hands, of course. And then get about 25 yards and get tackled right around here. Let's watch the play. Great route, corners it off, catches the ball. Three defenders around him. Brian Broad has brought this up before. Now, watch Tony Romo. He's going to point to Dez Bryant, who ran this route, drag route, across the field. There's Dez Bryant right here. Romo points to him, fakes out this linebacker. He's going to shoot in towards this way. This one's starting to backpedal more, but he's going to move forward, try to take care of Dez, which leaves Gavin Escobar full sprint towards this way and is wide open to make the catch. Romo points, throws it. Just a great job by Tony Romo. Watch it again. Romo steps up, points it, throws it. Excellent move by the quarterback. What a great catch by the tight end. Here's another route by Gavin Escobar. Line up again that slot position. He's going to run down the field along with Jason Witten. Now, he doesn't get the ball, but he's a little bit open. Romo instead throws the pass to his favorite guy, Dez Bryant. Gets off the snap. Now, right there, watch this linebacker. He dives down, try to protect Dez. Same with this guy, too, which leaves Jason Witten's a little bit open. There is his safety moving in, too. But Gavin Escobar is wide open right here to make the catch. Now, this linebacker could have probably come over and swat the ball. But as soon as Romo, you know, if he would have looked over and saw that this linebacker right here bit down on Dez, he could have snuck the ball in there to Gavin Escobar and get about a 25, 30-yard completion. He throws it to Dez. Makes the catch, but doesn't get the first down. Linebacker bites down. Right there, he's open. In these next few plays, we'll see why Gavin Escobar is not seeing the field that much. He's not the best run blocker. He's lined up on the outside right here. Randall's going to get the ball, run right behind him, and 53 is going to make the tackle. Let's watch the play. Gavin gets off the ball, does it not a good block on 53, who makes the tackle. Watch the play again. Does not do a good job at run blocking. Here's another run block by Gavin Escobar. He's lined on the outside. Watch him block this defender, and then Murray will take the ball and shoot this gap right around here. He goes in motion, goes back to the outside, gets driven back towards the middle, and Gavin Escobar's defender makes the tackle. Alright, now here we see the Cowboys coming out in a three tight end set. It's going to be a run play with Murray. He's going to shoot this gap. Now, Romo's going to motion James Hanna to play fullback right here. And then Gavin Escobar is going to block number 59. Keep your eye on this matchup right here. There goes James Hanna. Motion to fullback. And then Gavin Escobar thrown aside. And then 59 makes the tackle. Alright, now here we see actually a decent block by Gavin. He's lined up on 59 again. 59 doesn't do a good job of getting off the block as Gavin Escobar stands immediately upright and tries to block him. But Murray takes the ball and shoots off of Jason Witten and Gavin. He blocks him, and then Murray shoots right behind him. Watch how upright Gavin Escobar is. Stand straight up. Alright guys, this has been the last clip that I show of Gavin Escobar versus the run. Now he's lined up on the outside right here. It's the fourth quarter with about a minute 52 left, and Murray's going to actually take the ball, shoot the outside as the Giants come out with nine defenders, and they're pretty much going to, you know, shoot the middle and try to cause a lot of congestion. Now Murray definitely needs his first down to help secure the win. Watch Gavin Escobar try to block number 57 right here. He's going to take the ball, go to the outside, but 57 gets off Gavin Escobar's poor block and makes the tackle. Alright, this last clip that I show is actually with Jaron Parnell. This just shows you a true run block as the first play of the game, he sets the tone, drives number 94 right here, back about 10 yards. He also loses his helmet in the process too, which is kind of funny. Watch the play. Takes number 94, drives him back, and loses his helmet. He did have help from Jason Witten though, but just setting the tone right there. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Make sure to tune in next week as I break down Week 8's matchup versus the Washington Redskins.